And I'm back for part two, my Crash Bandicoot 2 playthrough. And I do apologize, hopefully my sound is a little bit better now. I'm still in the process of working things out, so let's get started. World number two. First level. Level 6. Snowbiz. Let's go. This is getting harder and harder, but you know we gotta have a lot of fun running over here. The penguins are already starting off. There's one great box right here. The haters of life. No. Now the penguins lay on their bellies. We got seals. If I recall, this was a level on a demo. Crash Bandicoot 2 demo. The hell? That's Sonic the Hedgehog.
Oh my god.
Or a relative. Get him with a slide attack. If I recall correctly, the boss of this world would be the Komodo brothers. Well, that was a close one. That was close. Why it comes in handy. Whoa! Close one. I freaked that. I ain't gonna lie. Why not? I'll go down here and get this. 23 lives. They don't give you too many lives on this game like they did in the first one. It seemed like every 5 boxes there was a life. Especially for a bonus round. Oh crap. I knew that was coming. It's hard to get that slide on that ice and die. Yeah, I'm not going back down there. The heck with those 2 lives. There's a life. Jungle rollers. Oh, so you can't kill the penguin when they're spinning? I should have known. One of the toughest enemies in this entire game is damn pain. This ice. I want to ask everybody something. Do y'all remember back in the day? When you used to be able to go to a video store like Blockbuster Video and rent movies and video games. And there's still, to this day, where I live at, there is a video store that still opens. It's called Family Video. Why in the world are they still open? I don't know. Who rents movies and video games nowadays? Other than, like, you got the Red Box out there. You got Redbox, Netflix. I mean, who goes to a video store and rents movies? I mean, if they do, they should be like damn near 99-cent a rental. I mean, I really don't understand. You got another ice level here? Oh, they combining all levels together now. Ice. Why can't... Okay, there we go. Water and ice stage, huh? But anyway, back to the video store. Yeah, it's still a video store. I think the last time I was in the video store to rent a movie was back on the PS3. PS2 was around. And they actually had GameCube games in there. I remember trying to rent GameCube games. The last video game I think I remember renting back then was like a Warriors Orochi 1. And that was on the PS2. So that was, you know how long that was ago, but I haven't been in a video store and I don't know how long. It's been like a good 10 years. It feels like. But they still exist. I'm thinking like, how the hell do they still exist? Are they still in business? Sense. I mean, what was the last game y'all rented from a video store? Blockbuster videos. All the Blockbuster videos are gone. But people from this new generation, they ain't gonna never know the struggle. You get to the video store, they only have one copy. The new game just came out, they only got one copy on the shelf, and it's always checked out. Always checked out. So you'll never be able to get... Crap. You'll never be able to get the game that's always, you know, that just came out. Because they might have two copies of it. And then always sold. They always sold out. When are you... I don't think I want to try to even try that. We'll go right in the water. Matter of fact, you know what? I'll try it. What the hell? Belly flap right inside the water. Yeah, so this video store, I might actually go into the video store and try to rent a game. I'm going to go in and try to rent a game and see if they have anything in stock, because I highly doubt that they will have anything on the shelf worth rentable. Especially, you know, nowadays, so. And I am not necessarily boycotting. Okay, I'm not about to even go for that anymore. Not necessarily boycotting GameStop, but I'm not trading anything no more at GameStop. I had went on a spree and bought everything that I used to own back in the day that I traded in when I was younger. Because I was actually kind of salty one day. That all started. I had the urge to play the video game on PS2 Rogue Galaxy. So I decided to go on my shelf for my PS2 games. I'm looking over my shelf to play Rogue Galaxy. I know it's Rogue Galaxy ain't on the shelf. So I'm thinking, what the hell? So I know I got this game. I know I had that game. I never did defeat it. I never got a chance to defeat it. But I didn't do one on the shelf. I had traded it in at GameStop back in the day. I was salty. So, you know, I'm going around trying to find this game, you know, the little video game stores. It sells used games and everything, you know, retro games. I couldn't find it nowhere. I finally discovered a place called Arcade Legacy, which they actually have arcade cabinets. It's kind of like a 16-bit, I don't know, a 16-bit arcade bar. They actually have old, old-fashioned games you can go there and play. Unlimited, as long as you buy something to drink. As long as you buy a drink, you can play all you want to. Arcade Legacy is kind of like that. But they have a lot of more game selections in there. You just don't have to play anything. You can buy the games. They have the system set up. You can buy games in there, trade in games, and you can just play. Arcade cabinets unlimited for $10. Or, you know, you can just go in there and try something out before you buy it. You know, you can go in there and put it inside the system. Sega Genesis, all systems. So it was pretty cool. So, you know, I ended up finding a copy of Rogue Galaxy. Actually, I didn't find a copy of Rogue Galaxy. I actually ordered off of Amazon. So by the time it came around, the day I ordered on Amazon and got it in the mail, the day before I got it in the mail, then that's when the PlayStation Network on the PlayStation 4 decided to remaster it and put it on the PlayStation 4. So I was kind of salty about that. So I'm like, really? So the game that I'm thinking of to trying to get, then you want to bring it out. Then you want to bring it out after I already paid and bought it. But I should have never got rid of it in the first place. And that started my whole journey of trying to get all my games back. So every single game back, regardless of if it's shitty or not, I got it back. Amazon or wherever I had to do to find it. Go around to the old used game store, so. This is one of my favorite levels. It's like Hog Wild 2.0. Slide on that ice. Instead of natives, we got seals. How the heck did I miss that damn? If I can do this level one. Oh shit. Whales. Checkpoint. This level pretty fun. Nitro! Oh shoot! Jump, jump! What? Slip! Checkpoint. Did I get the checkpoint? Oh my god. Shoot! I didn't jump right. Well, that's kind of cool. Crash gets frozen, but the polar bear doesn't. That's a tough-ass panda. That's a tough panda bear. That's a tough-ass polar bear. The Crash Bandicoot gets disintegrated, but the polar bear just sits there. He just gets singed a little bit. Yeah. How the... Okay. So now we're on that. I was nowhere near the hitbox of that explosion. It's definitely a little bit harder than Hog Wild. You gotta be on your P's and Q's or you'll test your reflexes. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Should've beat that the first try. I went back and got all my games that I literally traded in the past. I remember for some reason, I got everything back, including the Sonic the Hedgehog on PlayStation 3. That Sonic the Hedgehog, that was pretty much horrible. Camera was horrible. Shadow and the edit. The hell that Silver Hedgehog? Silver? That's his name? I think his name is Silver, yeah. They added him on there. I never beat it. I had bought it back in the day and I traded it in, but I actually got it back because I just got it back just because. I'm not trading anything anymore. So I'm gonna just hold on to everything now. Had to bring it all back. Now we got another boulder level. Oh, yeah. I didn't met. Landmines, so I can get hit by a TNT box and blow up and be nothing but draws, but I can step on a landmine and it just makes them slide. Okay, step on a landmine and it just does nothing. Okay, that's simple physics. Let's go. Wait a minute. That whole secret area here. Let's see what we got here. Shortcut? No, it's taking me back. Okay. Oh, we got another bowl. See, that's a trap right there. They set you up for that. You get that, you automatically gonna fly in the air and go right into the pit. That's a setup right there. I don't know why I just try to react to jump. Dodge all that. Slide. Stop doing that! Go. Right down the street. Bonus round. Thank you. huh? Was this not here? Belly flop. On down in the pit. I'm not about to. One away, that's messed up. Could have had it. That belly flop could have cost me my life. I ain't trying to get body. Here we go. Flying through this world. Whoa, dude, one level left. Here we go. The ill deal. I can stand there. Okay, this is scrubbing bubbles. Scrubbing bubbles. Go here. Electrifying water. Water electricity do not mix. Lights now with spikes now. Oh, whoa. Wait a minute now. Left or right? I guess I go this way because you got one. Toxic waste barrels. Go. Ooh, that was a close one. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do this. Yeah, I miss the days back in the day where you used to get the magazines, PlayStation magazines, or just the magazine, video game magazines in the mail. We used to come with a demo disc. See, I don't understand. Back in the day, they had money, they could print demo discs all the time. Like a whole bunch of mass production of demo discs. It didn't cost that much to do all that. So now it's like, nowadays we have to download our demos now, but it's like, how can they still can't just make us a disc? Demo disc anymore. How can we can't get that? I don't understand. Everybody subscribe to a magazine, get 12 issues a year. That means 12 demo discs. Plus codes in the back of the magazine. Roll up again. Good choice. They don't even put codes in games anymore. Everything's DLC now. You got DLC now. You want to unlock something and all that. It's like, nah, you can put that in and let us earn that stuff. What happened to the guide mode, the big head mode, all that kind of stuff? Oh, I guess I can't go this way. Play as the enemy code or something. You know what I'm saying? That kind of stuff. Level select. God mode. Infinite lives. I don't know how this, how that happened. Did I already get anything over here? Nope. Okay, come back. Belly fly. Oh, really? Really? I want to say you can take out those darn blades of that fan using enemies when you hit them, spin attack with. Best, so far, just time it the best you can and do your slide right through there. Otherwise, Crash Bandicoot's gonna go to glory again. Okay, this door is locked. Oh, we gotta go down. Okay. Oh, okay, we got something new here. Crash Bandicoot apparently has been working out at the gym, so he can actually he can hold himself up like that for long periods of time now. So, okay. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that upper body strength. See that? American Ninja Warrior right here material, look at that. Hot spikes, huh? I mean, not spikes, hot pipes, whatever that is. I did not know that. It's hard to tell the background, foreground. That must be his legs spinning. I was gonna say, how is he spinning while hanging from his hands? Alright. Now. Watch that. Okay. They're just looking at me. They're like some kind of enemy off of Sonic the Hedgehog or something. One box. One measly box. The ill deal. And here goes this guy again. Keeps dimming the lights and everything before he talks.
Crystals. You're on your way. I'm running low on power, so communication from this point will be difficult. Again, be wary of the pathways between warp ruins. Remember, I'm counting.
And we're going up. Cool, man. The Komodo brothers, I believe. Let's go. Oh, 2 versus 1, that's not very fair. Let's go, let's go. Spin attack, you get your crap right to his brother. Now dodge swords. Oh, okay. Just stay out of the range of his sword attack. Now he's gonna throw a few swords and I gotta dodge his brother. Oh, I can't get close? Huh. Okay, they give me a little fight, but... stay one step ahead of me. I cannot get hit. Let's go, let's go. Slip. Dodge. Dodge. Oh, he's trying to fake me out. Got him. Do the crash dance. And that's the ball game. They won too bad. Still to this day, I think the easiest boss was Koala Kong on the first game. So now we're up here in the area where we went from ice to land to water world.
Good show, Crash. The Komodo brothers obviously lacked your mettle. But now is not the time to get cocky. There are still many
crystals. I don't care, Cortex. I do not care.
The world is counting on you.
Why are you lucky about to cry? Well, go to the wall of saving. Well, I thank everybody for watching my videos. Please subscribe, like my channel if you can. I really appreciate it. I'm starting to get some stuff on here a little at a time, but I will have some more content coming out pretty soon. And hope everybody have a blessed day. And I'm sorry for the last few videos I made where my sound was a little off, but I'm getting everything together now. I'm getting the better. So, thanks for watching and have a good day.